Rudy Hayes Show with WBNS Sports Director Lee Vlisides is brought to you in part by Buckeye Federal Savings and Loan. And by Graham Ford, the big one where your dollar buys more, 707 West Broad. Here are Woody and Lee.
Sure, we have some problems this year, but we try not to advertise them. We're like any good poker player. We won't turn over any cards until we have to. Those are the words and the philosophy of Wayne Woodrow Hayes, the head football coach at Ohio State. As he enters his 26th year of coaching, Woody is as stormy, as intense, and as charming as ever. He is a man who lives in the eye of a hurricane, a man that knows what he wants and knows how to get it. W.W. Hayes, teacher, coach, philosopher, historian, a living, breathing time bomb. In short, Woody Hayes is Woody Hayes. Coach, how do you keep it up year after year?
Oh, I like to win. And if you're going to win, you're going to have the right people around you, and you're going to work like the Dickens. And sometimes that isn't enough, but I don't know of any other way to do it.
Associating with young people, does that keep you young year after year?
I'm sure it does. I'm sure it keeps any coach young. I'm sure it keeps any good teacher young, associating with young people, yes.
On this program, Coach, we're going to talk about a lot of things. We're going to talk about the people you have coming back, some of the people that you lost that you can't dwell on very long because
no, that's right.
There's only the future in football.
That's right. That's right.
Let's talk very briefly about the first day that you came out and put on the pads, that press day. Let's take a look at it and see how it looked through the eye of the camera.
Okay.
It's a fun day. Everybody comes out, the guys are all spiffed up in their brand new scarlet and white uniforms, and everybody's having a good time.
Well, not exactly. You know, in a way, we pass up a practice to get this. I don't know how the other coaches work it in because they seem to get it out of the way on Sunday and their physicals and everything else, but we can't get it done. By the rules, we have to do it on Monday, and we give up Monday morning practice.
How many practices can you get in before that first game?
Oh, I can't count them up, but we only go about 2 days in this second week of two-a-days. Otherwise, your legs get pretty dead.
Do you like the two-a-days?
Yes, I like them. I think it puts stress on a player, and this is what makes a player, is to put stress on him. We don't overdo it with them, but if they're not dog-tired after they've worked the two-a-days, they haven't been out there.
No. All right, you have to replace an awful lot of people on this Ohio State football team. Some great people graduated.
Yeah.
Is this the reason that some of the polls are playing the Buckeyes down?
I wouldn't know. I don't make up those polls, and frankly, I don't pay much attention to them.
Well, I don't blame him, because really...
No, you can't pay attention to those polls. They have a right to figure it any way they want to, and some of them have a little extra grind, and if they want to, that's their business, I guess. At least they're going to make it so, and so we just go ahead and play our ball game and let them play theirs.
Actually, they're just grabbing names out of a hat anyway. They haven't seen many of these guys play football.
No, they have something to go on. You take writers like Paul Horning and your other writers here in Columbus, and there are a few very good, knowledgeable writers throughout the country who can come pretty close on it.
We'll be back with more on the Woody Hayes Show in just a moment. Coach, if we were on the sand lots and we were choosing up sides to see who would get who, I think if I had my first pick, the man I'd take to start my football team would be Pete Johnson on your offense.
He's sure a good one, isn't he?
Oh, boy. Mm-hmm. Good and big and fast and everything.
I think he's going to give us his best year this year. Of course, this is 4 years of college football for him, and he played quite a lot toward the end of the season as a freshman. And I think you're right. We can expect a great season from him.
What about the quarterback slot, replacing Cornelius Green?
Well, the man who's replacing him, I don't know if he's good or not, but he's an awful lot like Cornelius. Has same quickness, same ability to pass, learns quickly, takes coaching well. They're very much alike.
Rod Gerald, he'll be wearing the number 8 this year?
Is that his number?
Yes.
Number 8.
Mm-hmm. Okay, about the tailback. Of course, you've got to replace a two-time Heisman winner. That's tough.
That is really tough. A youngster who's done an exceptional job, though, all spring and all fall, made very few mistakes, does everything well and is a fine leader in his own sort of quiet way is Jeff Logan. As a matter of fact, off the field, he's quite a bit like Arch. He takes a great interest in Christian emphasis, this sort of thing like Arch. He's very quiet about it, but he's a real quality young man all the way, and he's given us good practices every day. And we'll get some help, we think, from some of our freshmen.
You've got a little depth. Maybe it's young, but you've got some depth.
Yes, we think that'll come right along. But right now, Jeff is ahead of any of them.
Okay, replacing Brian Bashnagel is not going to be easy at the wingback.
No, that isn't. But we have Jim Harrell, who's a senior, and he's also one of those quiet, quality youngsters. He, I believe, is president of the Christian group on the campus. And his legs are the best they've been in years. He's had bad legs ever since he's been with us. In high school, he gained, I think, 2,600 yards his senior year. And in the All-Star game that summer, he was the outstanding back, but he's been hurt ever since. But his legs are considerably better this fall, and we gave him a couple days off now to freshen him up to get him ready to go for next week.
Okay, and you've got some good offensive linemen. Chris Ward comes to mind, a man as big as a house.
Yeah, maybe we better go through these teams now. Let's see, we mentioned the quarterback, the fullback, the tailback, and we got the wingback, didn't we?
Right.
And that's about the way it'll start there. And Chris Ward, of course, we don't think there's a better offensive tackle anywhere. He's an honor student again, and great work habits, intelligent, and he weighs almost 280 pounds, and he'll run about a 4.75 40, and that's about what your fullbacks normally run. And he just, he's in there on every play, and he's a darn good one and a great youngster to coach. Along beside him, a fellow that's been having a little knee problem, not serious, is Jim Moore. He's also big and played a lot last year as a freshman, and of course would be a starter, but he's been banged up a little bit lately, and a fellow named Greg Storr has been in there, but I think Jim will be in by next Saturday. And at the other tackle, we have Nick Petrini. That isn't quite
Lou.
It. Lou Petrini, I'm sorry. Lou Petrini, who is in his fifth year, and he's got one not too good leg, but he plays all the football he knows how to play, and he gives you a good, consistent game, but he doesn't have two good legs under him. Yeah. And then, of course, we have Captain Billy Lucas in there at one of the guards. And at the other, it could be Jim Savoca, or we could put Ron Ayers there. But I imagine we'll start Ron Ayers at center for the first game. He started four games at center last year. You see, Ron and Pete and Billy Lukens are the only seniors who started games for us last year on offense.
Coach, that Ohio Stadium has seen some superb football players come and go. I just wish that stadium had ears and a mouth to tell us all about it. Let's take a look at this, kind of an arty look at a practice session out at the Ohio Stadium. That's, Coach, before we get into talking about the defense, is all this hassle out of East Lansing, has that been distracting to you or your ball club?
I don't think the ball club, a man doesn't like to be called a cheat when he isn't, and that's all we're going to say about it.
Okay.
And I haven't any time to spend on it.
All right, the defense,
the charges,
Coach,
are ridiculous. But to get to the defense now, it's a much better topic, and we've got that line pretty much anchored with men of last year, with Nick Bonamici, a senior there at the one tackle, and Eddie Beeman, a junior who started last year, and Aaron Brown in the middle. The two linebackers both started last year, Ed Thompson, our captain, and Tom Cousineau started four games last year. So that's experienced in there. Bob Brzezinski is an outstanding and all Big Ten end already at the open side. In the sideline, we have a little fellow named Kelton Danzler, about 200 pounds, but very quick and very tenacious. So that line will hold its part quite well. We have two of the four men in the backfield. We have Ray Griffin at safety, who made the biggest play of anybody last year up there, up north in that last game when he intercepted the one, took it into the three-yard line. And the other one, Bruce Rule, is a senior and has started, this will be his third year at that boundary halfback. Will be new at the corner in the place of Timmy Fox, and will be new at the open side halfback in the place of Craig Cassidy. That open side halfback will probably be Lenny Mills, a sophomore, who started three games last year, and Joe Allegro will start at the corner, who was a safety man and backed up Ray Griffin last year. And both those men have looked quite good.
All right, on paper, the defense looks tremendous. Will this change the game plan, the game philosophy at all? I mean, will you kick more? Will you play more to the defense?
Well, I don't think we'll punt on first down, Lee, or anything like that. We will depend on that defense playing good ball for us, but they've always, over the years, gotten us the ball in good field position. And, of course, the thing that ties the two of them together, and we have the man who represents that, our kicking game. That's the third factor in it. Between the offense and the defense, the kicking game, which is a sort of catalyst and ties them together. But our game won't change much, no. We'll run the ball a lot and pass a little, but the last 2 years we've led the league in passing percentages. Now, we don't like to pass very much because that softens you up. We don't like that kind of football.
But Tom Scladini can get you great field position, can't
he? Yes, he does a great job. We'll have him on the show for a few minutes yet and have him talk about not only the punting, but the kickoff.
Coach, staying healthy is very important for any football team. Let's take a trip to the OSU training room where they care and maintain Buckeyes.
This is the Buckeye football training room, only an hour before practice, and as you can see, it's a very busy place.
We're talking about 110 ball players, and of course we tape all our athletes. So now we're in a situation where we've been in camp for about 10 days, and of course we've begun to have more injuries. So of course with the taping of the ankles, you also get your knees and what have you. And this of course takes a lot of time. So we have approximately an hour and 15 minutes to get out about 110 ball players.
To work on over 100 football players, the OSU training staff will use over 2,000 miles of tape and around 100 gallons of analgesic for the bumps and bruises. The trainers also have a new machine called the NeuroSceptor.
Of course, we started using it last spring and have been getting amazing good results in it. What it does, it does not cure or heal an injury, but it helps to just cut down and eliminate the pain. And it's a send down electrodes of stimulants to the nerve endings, and it blocks off the pain sensation from the muscle.
Another interesting thing you had out there was the paraffin bath for, I guess, tendonitis, things like that.
Right. I found, as a matter of fact, with our defensive backs, Raymond Griffin had it last week, and of course Lennon Mill has it now, that they're getting tendonitis of the Achilles. And what happens is that you get an inflammation of the tendon around the joint. And using a paraffin bath is really good for the simple reason there's a wax, but in this wax there's heat, and the heat can conform around the contour of the ankle joint and helps to relieve a lot of the soreness.
Hill says injury prevention is a main theme at OSU, and he stresses that serious injuries have decreased since the Buckeyes started using the Nautilus weight training system several years ago. According to Hill, AstroTurf has also helped.
My own personal feeling is that, I like working with AstroTurf for the simple reason I don't get the major injuries as far as the knees. Back in 71, we had something like 19 knee surgeries. Now, I did a survey the following year, and when over the old films of 71 and come to find out that the majority of the injuries that occurred happened before or after the play and was not a result of the turf itself. So I cannot say that, AstroTurf is attributed to any major injuries. The only nagging injuries that we do have are your skin abrasions and your jammed big toe. But these are day-to-day type injuries, and of course, these are one that we can deal with on a day-to-day basis.
Including a complete dentist office, doctor's office, and a competent staff headed by Billy Hill and Dr. Bob Murphy, the Buckeye Medical Training Facilities are among the best in the nation. Injuries are a part of football, but at OSU, every effort is being made to make them as small a part as possible. This is Stan Radford reporting.
Coach Hayes brought with him tonight Nick Bonamici, defensive tackle, and linebacker Ed Thompson. Coach, these fellows have been having a pretty good early practice, haven't they?
Yes, they've both done very well, and I don't believe either one of them have missed a practice, which is very important now. Ed, is you go into your senior year now, and as captain of the team, how do you approach your senior year with any difference than you played your other 2 years of football?
Well, I think that being a senior, you always want your leadership out of your seniors, because if you don't have your senior group as leaders, then your teams, aren't that quite that good. But so we try to go in as leaders and get in good shape so that we set an example, I guess.
I think that's right. Nick, would you go along on that?
Yes, sir.
What kind of leadership do you try to give the squad?
I don't really try to give my leadership in talking. I try to do it on the field,
yeah,
and the way I play and the way I carry on myself.
Nick never gives you a bad practice and rarely a bad play. And on the field, he's a great example.
He likes that contact, doesn't he?
Yeah,
Coach?
He likes that contact, and he is going, even if he doesn't ring the bell, he's always going after
him. He's going after even the big guys.
Yeah, and this is real football. And between these two fellows, you see, we don't have many seniors.
Four, Coach.
Well, you have four. Right. Who are the others?
It's Bob Brzezinski and Bruce Rule.
Yeah, we better get them on the show then soon, had we, huh? Bob was an All-Big Ten end last year, and Bruce Rule's been a starter now for 2 years. And those two fellows are fine leaders, too, in their own quiet, efficient sort of way. But you do have to look at it a little differently than you did any year up to now. You have to assume more responsibility, don't you, Nick?
That's right.
Yeah, yeah. And these two fellas play that kind of ball. Ed has to be a little more vocal because he's a captain. But, incidentally, you came here, as a
Quarterback.
Mm-hmm. I see. And now you're a linebacker.
That's right.
You like it at that position?
Oh, sure.
Yeah. And what did you weigh when you came, do you remember?
I was about 185, Coach.
Yeah, you were. When I
you
came
were?
Down to see you play basketball, they had him really trimmed down. He was an all-high basketball player. I went down, I wondered at that time if he'd ever get big enough. What do you weigh now?
220.
Mm-hmm. Now, Nick went the other direction. Should we tell him, Nick, what happened? Nick came here at 280. Now he's down about 240. And he's a lot better football. It's solid, and he can move. But these are two fine football players, and you'll see a lot of football out of them a week from today.
Coach, you mentioned that the two fellas, Nick and Ed, had not missed a practice. I know that you keep very close tabs on who does and who doesn't.
Sure. Oh, sure. We try to keep them into every practice. If you do, they get tougher and in better condition, and the chances of injury are much, much, much less if you never miss a practice.
Actually, that's one of the things you chart, isn't it? You have charts everywhere.
We have charts on everything. Sure. We want to see where we're going and where we came from. And we do have a lot of charts, and I think the players are interested in them. I don't think we better take any longer with these men tonight, because we've got three other men to talk to, and we're running pretty close on time.
Well, why don't we just bring those the offensive players in, Ace, and I'll just take my microphone off here. And
I think
Nick,
we just better keep coming if we can get them to move fast.
Luke, you got to move. Well, here comes a man who knows how to move, Coach. Pete
and
Johnson.
He knows how to move other people, too.
Thanks, gentlemen. But, just step right in here in front of me. Nick, just step over here by the coach.
All right.
Keep that
we'll,
in there.
We'll let you stand over
I'll let
here.
I'll you hold that, Luke.
Sort of get in the back.
Tom, can you slip in here?
Let's get Tom in it, too, while we're here. All right, let's start with Billy Lukens, our captain, and we'll be starting his third year as a starter. He started some as a sophomore, didn't you? But mainly as a junior, now he's a captain. Billy is in pre-veterinary medicine and will be in veterinary medicine this fall. Am I correct?
Correct.
He carried about a 3.7 going into that. And Pete is a senior. Pete played a lot in the Rose Bowl game, a lot in the game up north as a freshman, right?
That's great.
He's been a starter now for 3 years. And Pete is another fellow who leads by example. Are you in as good shape as you were a year ago?
Well, Coach, I think I'm in better shape than I were a year ago. I worked out a lot harder this summer at it, and I've been in every practice, so I have to be.
Your legs aren't quite right today, though. The films I looked at tonight, you're not as sharp as you were 3 days ago.
That's from a lot of work, Coach.
Yeah,
he's getting tired. He's getting tired, Coach. He's getting tired.
But you're not running as well as you did on Thursday. So by you get a day's rest, get up and get in the training room tomorrow morning.
Do you believe in the thing they call heavy legs, Coach?
Oh, sure. Well, they know about it, sure. And we'll have them ready, though. Now, we've only got about 1 minute left, and I didn't mean to throw Pete off, but we get over now to Tom Skladany. Tom has had some heavy legs, too. And he's doing her punting and her kickoff. And what causes you to have heavy legs?
Coach, for the runners, it's just too much running and, running through practice all day. But I just pulled a muscle 2 days ago or 3 days ago, and it was just too much kicking.
Did anybody make you do too much kicking?
No.
The
other kickers had sore legs, so I was taking two practices a day, and my leg got tired, and it just went. They'll be ready for Monday.
But they'll be ready Monday.
This week.
And Peter ready Monday, and Bill, and these two are always ready, right?
But, Coach,
so I think we're running out of time. We better wind it up now. But these are the kind of football players you win with. That may not be good grammar, but it's a good way to win.
To close the show, Coach, I have a piece of trivia for you.
Oh?
Do you know who has the most academic All-Americans in the Big Ten?
Yeah, we do.
Right.
Oh, sure.
By far, Ohio State. Good luck, gentlemen, against Michigan State and during the 1976 season. Coach, best of luck.
Thank you. That's it.
Next week, we'll have highlights of the Michigan State victory. Join us at 11:30 Saturday.
The Woody Hayes Show with WBNS Sports Director Lee Vlisides was brought to you in part by Buckeye Federal Savings and Loan. And by McDonald's Restaurants of Columbus and Central Ohio.